welcome to my channel. This tutorial is the first of a series of different tutorials of how to make components for a 2D platformer game. In this tutorial, we will be creating a very simple tile map with a player with idle and run animations. For the assets in this tutorial, I'm using Warped Caves by Antimus, and this can be found at itch.io, which are free to download. I will leave this link in the YouTube description. Now let's head over to Godot and start to create our project. So click New Project, give the game a project name, we'll leave it at a forward render, choose your folder to save the game, and then just remember to create the folder for the game. I'll click None for this option because we don't want any version control, and click Create and Edit. I have a preferred editor layout, so I'm just going to set my layout first. So feel free to move around your tabs if you wish to use an editor layout that's similar. I find that it's very easy to have my file system on the left hand side, and then I can filter my files here. The history tab is next to that. Then I have a scene, an import tab, inspector, and then node. And then my main viewport is here where I can view my 2D nodes, and I can also review my scripts as well. And we can run the game here. When you're happy with your layout, you can save your layout here and then recall that later. Okay, let's begin by creating a very simple tile map. Click on 2D scene, and you can rename your scene by just pressing F2 and then type level. And then add a child node and choose the tile map node. In the tile map node, what we want to do is want to create a tile set, but first what I'd like to do is just create a new folder to store my tile set in, and then head over to the Warped Assets collection which you've downloaded, bring them over, and then in the Warped Files, under PNG, in Environment, go to Layers, and then we want this tile set here. So what we can do, we can click and drag that over into our tile set, but then just drop that and move that into the folder. And then let's rename this. I'm just going to call this game tile set 1. Okay. And then in the tile set here, we just click create new tile set. And then we'll get a tab down here that where we can add that. So we've got tile set and tile map. Now click tile sets here and drag it over into your tiles. And it will ask you if you want to auto create your tiles using the Atlas texture. So what we'll do, we'll click yes, and it will automatically detect all the tiles within that tile set. Now for this tutorial, we're just going to create a very simple platform for the player to be able to stand on and move and run along. So zoom in on the tiles, and we're just going to choose this tile. But first, we need to just configure a little bit more in our tile map. So we need to create a layer, and we'll just call this ground. And what we need to do, we also need to create some physics as well for that. So now click on tile set and add one physics layer. So the physics layer will be added to the tile, and each physics layer gets a layer name. So what we can do, we've got layer 1, layer 2, layer 3, 4, and so on. But what we want to do is we want to put our ground on layer 1. So open up the edit layer names, and in layer 1, type the word ground. Then you'll see that layer 1 is now been named as ground, and the collision mask is also ground. So we can leave that as it is. Now pop over to your tile set again and click select and select the tile that we want to use. So we want to use this tile, and then in the physics option, in the physics layer 0, which corresponds to this physics layer here, click inside this box here and press F on the keyboard to activate the layer. And what it's now done, if we zoom in, we now have a collision box that fits that tile perfectly. And what that will do, that will apply that to the tile. So what we can do, we can click paint, and if you select the physics layer again, you can click other tiles and they will paint other tiles. But for now, we're only going to keep this simple one for a very simple tile map. So that's all now configured. What we'd like to do is go over to our tile map, select the tile that we'd like to paint, and then you can start to paint it. To make this a little bit quicker, if you click the rectangle box here, we can then draw our platform. And that's everything for a very, very simple tile map. Now let's save our level, go to new folder, call it levels, and save our level scene. So scene, save scene, choose levels, and click save. Now that we have a simple platform, let's begin creating our player. So click scene, new 2D scene, and what we want to do is we want to change this node. So we can go to change type. We want a character body 2D. This is a special node which we can use for moving characters and other things like enemies. So change, and we'll see the icons change now. Let's rename that node to player and create a new folder to store our player information in. So create that and let's save that scene. So we say save scene and pop it into the player folder. For this player, we want to create idle and run animations. So let's add a child node, and what we'll use is animated sprite 2D node. So we've got animated sprite 2D, create that node. And then we need to create some sprite frames. So click new sprite frames and then open that. And we are given our sprite frames window. So in this window, we can create new animations for idle and run, change the frames per second for the animations, loop and auto load. So now head over to the warped collection again and go into PNGs, sprite sheets, player, and now find our player idle and player run animation sprite sheets. So drag them over into the player folder. And let's begin creating our first animation. So click new animation, F2, or double click, and name this idle. We'll click the add frames from sprite sheet option, go into the player folder and click player idle. What we now need to do is now to have one image per frame. So we need to change our vertical option. We've already got four in the horizontal, so we don't need to change that. And then just click and add the frames. What we can now do is zoom in on the player and click play, and it will start to animate those frames. Let's increase the frames per second to speed this up. 10 is okay, so we'll leave this on looping so that the animation keeps looping around. And because this is the very first animation in our set, we will click auto load, because we always want, when the player comes into view, the first animation to be idle. Let's create our run animation. And click add sprite frames again and click the player run sprite sheet. Again, reduce vertical to 1 and increase horizontal until we fit all the images into each frame. So there are 10 frames in this sprite sheet. Let's highlight them all and add 10 frames. Let's click play to run the animation and increase the frames per second to speed the animation, or get the correct speed for our animation. And 12 is okay, so we'll leave looping on, and we're not going to auto load this because we don't want our player character to be running automatically when it comes into view. Okay, let's pause that animation, let's set back to idle again, and then click our player option here. Now zoom in on the player, and we can see that the asset and the pixels in this are blurred. Now this is going to be a pixelated game, so we want pixel perfect assets. Now click project settings. We need to make a change to the renderer, and in general, under rendering in textures, if you look at the default texture filter, we have linear, and we need to pop this onto Neera. So return this to Neera and go close. We can now see that we've got better pixelation in our asset. The next thing we'd like to do is to move our asset so it sits on the x-axis. So the feet are slightly just below the x-axis, and we can do this by clicking animated sprite and moving our sprite up. Now, I don't want to do this on the player node because I would like to keep the origin on the x-axis. So we can see with this icon here, it's on there, and I want to just move the sprite up itself. So click on animated sprite and go to transform position and change the y-axis. And then we can see that the feet are just touching that. If you then click on idle and play, you can see that the animation is running, and then click run and zoom in again, and the feet are just touching the x-axis. Just pause that and zoom back out, pop it back onto idle. So again, look at the player node, and we've just currently got a warning message on here. And what we need to do, we need to add a collision shape. So add a new node, search for collision shape, click create. And in the collision shape, we also need to add a shape, and that's what this warning message is for. So we need to click this option and go to capture shape 2D. And again, the capsule is at the x-axis 0, so we just need to move this as well. So pop this roughly in the middle and then drag that open, expand that, and make modifications here and just reduce that a little bit. Make it a bit smaller. Okay, that fits my player perfectly. Now that we've got a catch-all collider for the player, we want to then go back to player node, scroll down, and this is for the physics and the collisions. So if we hover over layer one, we can see we have that ground layer, but we want to put our player on a different layer. So we'll do that on layer two. You click this option here, edit layer names, and in layer two, add player, close, and change the layer that the player is going to be on. So deactivate one, but the mask we're going to leave at one, because what we want to say, we want to say the player has its own collision and layer, but the player should detect the ground. Now that brings us to the end of this tutorial. Watch the next tutorial where we add a player script and take inputs from the keyboard to make the player move. If you like the content of this tutorial, please remember to click like and subscribe, and thank you for watching.